marketing. Well, here we're at the very beginning of this course, and let's kind of think about what marketing is. And we kind of, when you're starting off like this, maybe thinking of marketing in kind of narrow terms. Oh, you're thinking it's selling, it's advertising, it's promotion. Maybe it's making and distributing products or creating service offerings that wind up going to your customers or channel members. But marketing is a whole lot more than that. When we use the term marketing, what we mean as a marketer, a marketing person, it's a way of thinking. It's a way of doing things. It's a philosophy of how you deal with your customers, your employees, society, and the environment, through which we have the activities of the four P's. Let's see. There's your product, promotion, price, and place. That's what they are. So probably the best place that we can get started here is by kind of defining what we mean by marketing. So to define marketing, oh dear, I'm not sure this is the American Marketing Association's definition of marketing, but hey, it's mine. It's an organized system of activities designed to get the money out of somebody else's pockets and into yours. Yes, absolutely. We're out in this business to get our objectives, but let's make a caveat on that. I'm out to get my objectives, but I'm also out to help my customer get their objectives and what they want as well. We're creating a win-win environment here, and we'll get into that later on. We talk about some of the marketing ethics, but not a question about it. We know what it is that we are looking for. Now, within marketing, one of the key concepts is the concept of exchange. And when we have exchange, what we're saying as the key element of marketing, each party is going to give up something of value to get something from the other party that they consider to be of greater value. It's that simple. That's why you trade something. Profit objective? Not necessarily. It does not have to be a profit objective. The only key to this thing is that each party has something that is considered to be of value to the other party, and each party is free to deal with or not deal with the other party. So, traditional example. You get your hard-earned money for a cold 12-pack and an on-demand movie at day's end. Yeah. Second possible example, your vote for Rand Paul or Paul Ryan or whomever to advance your own political, social, and personal interests. Third possibility, you volunteering your time to work with a public service organization. You're doing volunteer work for whomever. You're getting a sense of personal fulfillment out of it. You're getting a good line on your resume. It certainly is going to look awfully good when you go to the job interview and you can cite all the community service. So you got a trade. You're giving the time and you're getting something back in return. Or here's one, been an interesting marketing campaign in recent years. Your decision to take a cab when you're impaired. This is Mothers Against Drunk Driving, trying to get people to think about something that 15, 20 years ago no one thought about too much. Hey, going to be drinking tonight. I either need to give up the keys or take a cab or basically just not get behind the wheel. That's a transaction, folks. At the moment that you say, I'm hanging the keys up tonight, somebody else, you guys doing the driving, or you turn the keys to a friend and say, hey, I ain't doing it tonight, or you call a cab, that's the moment of a transaction. That's the same thing as what you might have done had you purchased something at the grocery store, handing over the cash to get something in return. So we really have a whole variety of contexts in which marketing takes place. Let's take a note now at the four different kinds of marketing philosophies that might be in operation. And the first one of those is the production orientation. Now, the production orientation kind of started in the period post-World War II. And that was a whole different world back then, folks, because basically, think about it. The U.S. was the only nation standing at the end of the war. All you had to do was produce a product. Somebody's there ready to buy it. And I can remember my grandfather in 1947, the second year the cars were being made, he gets a phone call from the local Oldsmobile dealer saying to him, hey, we got a black 1947. You want it? That's all you had to do back in those days. Produce a product. Someone's there. But that production orientation essentially says, what can we make? What do we do best? And so what the organization does is sets its goals and strategies based upon what it can most easily design and produce.